Good evening, you're watching The Logical Indian. I'm Navya Singh and I'll take you through the most important developments of the day. A minor boy and a CRPF personnel were killed in a terrorist attack on the security forces in Jammu and Kashmir's Anantnag today. The attack on the security forces took place at around 12 p.m. when the terrorists opened fire at a CRPF patrol party which was deployed for highway security. During the attack, a CRPF personnel and a 12-year-old boy sustained bullet injuries. However, they later succumbed to the injuries when they were taken to a hospital and declared dead. A second wave of flood has hit the state of Assam, affecting over 2.2 lakh people in as many as 13 districts in the state. The water levels in the river Brahmaputra and its tributaries continue to rise and the flood waters continue to enter the affected areas in the state. Yesterday, one person drowned due to the flood, taking the death toll to 15 in the state. At least 17 organizations and 22 journalists wrote a strongly worded open letter to Karnataka High Court Judge Justice S. Krishna Dixit over his recent remarks that he made while granting bail to a rape accused. The letter strongly states that the order disturbs and disappoints all those who have been working for decades to get rid of the deeply rooted patriarchy in the social and political systems in the country. In the judgment, ladies and gentlemen, the judge noted that the complainant's explanation that she was tired and had fallen asleep after the sexual assault is unbecoming of an Indian woman and that this is not the way our women react when they are ravished. The judge also pointed out that the woman had stayed out late in her office till 11 p.m. and had stayed until morning. The judge also noted that she had consumed drinks and sat in the car with the accused. Now, after these damning statements came out to light, the letter written to the judge also mentioned that instead of looking at the legal merits of granting the accused bail, the woman was judged on misogynistic grounds, which has nothing to do with the law. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today said that Uttar Pradesh will generate as many as 1.25 crore jobs in the coming days, with special focus on rural areas and small-scale industries amid the return of lakhs of migrants to the state in the last 3 months. PM Modi, along with UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, launched the Atmanirbhar Uttar Pradesh Rojgar Yojana today. Prime Minister also said that investors from India and abroad are looking at UP as an ideal destination to set up businesses. In a good news, NASA has decided to rename its Washington headquarters after the name of Mary Jackson, who's NASA's first black female engineer. The NASA administrator said that Mary never accepted status quo and that she broke barriers and created more opportunities for African American and women in the field of engineering and technology. She was also a research mathematician and later went on to become the first black female engineer for NASA. That's all for today. I'll be back with some more important news tomorrow. Thanks for watching.